we're about to get started on the last part of the convention, the business meeting, but before we do, you noticed there were some of your colleagues up here actually buying some stuff. It makes the trip back to San Antonio a little bit lighter, so if anybody wants to lighten our trip a little bit more, that would be wonderful. I've decided to shame the faculty. The students, I understand, maybe don't all have a lot of money, but surely the faculty can spring for something. And many of the faculty have already done that. So it'll be out until right after the meeting, but after that, that's your last chance to get these discounted right.
$15 going fast. This little pin would look great on a jacket for any faculty who wants a little Sigma Zeta pin, only $5. Or any students that will be presenting, they're going at a great rate.
Gamma Eta.
Here.
All right. So just a couple of things. I want to have all the advisors stand up. Advisors are all volunteers, so would our volunteer advisors stand up? If you're an advisor for a chapter, please stand. And I would like for our students to, and everybody to clap for these people. That's really, really an important thing. I would like everybody who's presented to stand up. So if you've done a poster or an oral presentation, because I just want to see how many there are. Look at this huge group of students, right? Look around. This is a huge group of really great students. And had the courage, right, to get up here. And all of them should come up and get a certificate.
That'll be a little later.
A little later, yeah.
We actually have, these are hands signed by all 8 of the national officers. Each and every one of them took us a few minutes.
Okay, and without the support of your fellow classmates, so some of you, right, aren't ready to present your research, and so you did not. So I'd like all the students who are here but didn't present research to stand up. So we hope that you have another opportunity to come, and that during that time you choose to do a presentation of your undergraduate research. Hopefully that we fund it, right? Some of you are here that we funded and you haven't had an opportunity yet to present. It's really important that you get out there and show us what you did. Don't forget all the updates and stuff, right? Chapter reports. I think our chapter needs to do one, right? Chapter reports need to be submitted online. Research updates, so if you didn't present this year but you got an award from Sigma Zeta, please do that. And final reports, so if you have finished your work and are doing a final report, please get those in. Those all get submitted to the website. It's super easy to do. Okay? We have a wonderful webmaster who's made it piece of cake. 1, 2, 3. Okay? So just do that for us. And last but definitely not least, Marian University. We really appreciate all the things that you guys have done. Can your whole chapter stand, all the people that are present, stand for us? Okay, now I got to put my president's hat on a little bit and talk about the state of Sigma Zeta. Sigma Zeta is a strong organization, and it's because of you. Every single one of you make a difference. By what you do in your local chapter, by coming here, all of it matters, right? Whether you're doing science outreach, which several student groups are doing a lot of, right? Or you're doing your undergraduate research project at home, at your home institution, this is good stuff. And we need to promote and continue to promote that. The organization has money, and we're trying to put that in the right places, right? We're trying to fund undergraduate research projects. So if you have a project and you're working on it and you need a little bit of extra money, now it's not a big award, but right, it's something to help you along the way to get your research off and going, or keep it going, or make it better, right, so that you can come and present. Don't forget, those are due in October, right? So October is the deadline for research awards, and you'll find out by December, yeah? So that's kind of the timeline, and we want to make sure that you're aware of that. That's a way that we're spending your dollars wisely, right? We don't want to waste the money that you spend. It's hard-earned money, and you guys are poor college students. I heard that several times when I asked them to buy water bottles or backpacks or something. I have $5, not 15. That's okay. We have pins, right? So... but we're a strong organization, and we're trying really to be responsive to our membership, and we hope you recognize that, and we hope it continues. The number of chapters is growing. We're getting really close to approaching 100 chapters. That's also a big deal. because for a long time we were a very small group and didn't have many chapters coming to the national. Now we have a regular crew coming to the national, and so we want to keep that number growing. Let's see, what else do I want to say? Overall, I hope you've had a good time at the national, and that you've had an opportunity to meet people from other chapters and find out what other chapters are doing that you can take home and use at your home institution. So whether that's science outreach, or a new idea for a fundraiser, or maybe just a collaboration on a project, you got another idea for your project at home, all that stuff is important, right, and good. And maybe you saw some things at the science museum, or the art museum, about science, right, of painting and got inspired, or you listened to the speaker talk about science entrepreneurship. So, I mean, how impressive is that, that Dr. Zeta has done so many different things, right? Really cool. And married, really, right, science and entrepreneurship skills to create things that hadn't been done before and make life easier, right? Make life better. And so hopefully you continue to look at your challenges in your research when it doesn't work, because it doesn't always work, right? And you look at that as a challenge, not as a giant hurdle that you can't overcome, right? You have to look at it as it's a roadblock, maybe temporarily. And what they've seen again and again in studies is that, right, that grit and determination that you have is a lifelong skill that will help you in whatever you do, whether you go on to be a doctor, or whether you go on to be a scientist, or a mathematician, or a business owner, an entrepreneur in the computer science industry. It doesn't matter to us, right? What matters to us is that you're contributing to the enterprise, right? And you're learning how to be good citizens of science and good communicators of science so that we can continue to solve some of the challenging problems of the world. And with that, right, I hope that you continue to be a part of Sigma Zeta, even after you graduate, to check in on our website and see what's going on, and maybe one day be a speaker at a national event, because what you're doing is so cool. Huh? Thank you for giving me the opportunity to serve. And I guess we'll then continue with committee reports. Okay, so the first committee is the auditing committee. So for the auditing, I don't know how the auditing committee is presenting.
Just come forward. Right?
Yeah, come forward. The auditing committee should come forward.
While people are coming forward, I'll mention that I'm Ross Holmes from Alva College, and I was the chair of this. But my, a special thanks to Dr. David Hahn, who has been our treasurer and does a wonderful job for us. And I'm looking for Dr. Hahn right now, by the way. Oh, there he is. And so he made the job really very, very easy, I should say. Maybe I shouldn't say easy, but it was very efficient because he was so well organized. But our committee, they have a plan, don't they? Don't we? Who was I starting with? So they're going to say their name, where they're from, and then a quick report.
I'm Maddie Mitchell, and I'm from Beta Eta at Evangel University.
I'm Yama Allen, and I'm from Beta Eta at Evangel University.
We checked the reports, and the income and expenses on the treasurer's report were verified to be accurate.
I'm Jordan Greer. I'm from Alpha Beta at Campbellsville University.
And I'm Jessica Gama, and I'm from Beta
Eta,
Evangel University.
I'm Elizabeth Schweitzer. I'm from Pi, and that's from Milliken University.
We checked three random invoices to make sure that Our Lady of the Lake account was verified that we had receipts for withdrawals.
I'm Alyssa Matska from the Beta Iota chapter, which is about the University.
I'm Maddie Howard from the Gamma Gamma chapter from Concordia Moorhead University. I'm Ariana Huber. I'm from Gamma Gamma from Concordia College.
I'm Luke Tigan from Gamma Gamma, also Concordia College.
We checked the, we picked three random checks from the region's checking account and verified that the checks and the receipts match.
I'm Stephanie Neal from the Sigma chapter, Arlie's the Lake University.
I'm Anna Johnson. I'm from Alpha Gamma, which is at Marian University.
I'm Alyssa Foster from Gamma Kappa, which is at Southwest Baptist University. We checked invoices and verified that there are receipts to match and they all did.
Yes. So is there a motion to accept the report of the auditing committee?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Any abstention? Okay. Is that a pass?
Thank you.
Resolutions committee? Please come forward.
Shall provide proper instructions for kinetic sand before an attempt is made.
I'm Laura Mayton from Alpha Beta from Hamilton University. Armed guards shall be posted at each entrance to make sure no other students try to come in.
I'm Father Yadris from the Sigma chapter at Our Lady of the Lake University. Whereas Northern schools should not call tea sweet until it is approved by an attendee from either Kentucky or Missouri.
My name is Eva Gunnerman. I'm from the Phi chapter at Eureka College. Whereas notifications will be provided that the zoo will be a madhouse since the entire city is on spring break.
I'm Allison Cormican, and I'm from Gamma Kappa Chapter, Southwest Baptist University. Whereas microphones will be turned on during the question portion of talks.
I'm Brittany Miller from Beta Eta Chapter at Emmanuel University. And whereas chairs should be comfortable in all situations, and that's all.
Suttles. I'm from the Beta Eta chapter at Evangel University. And whereas attendees shall be forced into more socially awkward situations with other chapters, and
I'm Paige Stansel from the Roe chapter of the University of Indianapolis. Whereas a place to upload PowerPoints and posters be made so that they be referenced by students when they get back to their universities and say, oh yeah, I remember that one talk.
I'm Carly Nicholson from the Roe chapter at the University of Indianapolis. Whereas each attendee shall purchase a minimum of one Sigma Zeta branded item so that officers may so that office may be cleared and new merchandise ordered.
Hi, my name is Noah Holmes. I'm from Beta Eta at Evangel University. Whereas resolution committees shall meet prior to dinner when people are funnier.
Hello, I'm Carrie Bell from the Beta Iota chapter at Bethel University. And whereas all chapters shall account for their attendees prior to going back to the hotel so that Uber doesn't have to be called out.
Okay, I'm Ben Stubbs from Gamma Gamma at Concordia College, and we have to see where we at. Oh, whereas if you are given an honor award, banquet attendance is optional.
I'm Michael Schultz from the Gamma Gamma chapter at Concordia College. Whereas meetings that start prior to 9 a.m. may have attendees straggling in.
I'm Megan Donlinger from the Gamma Gamma chapter at Concordia College. And whereas the field trips were incredible and...
Keep going.
Whereas furniture trucks must stay in their lane for the duration of the Sigma Zeta conference.
Whereas special thanks to Rels of Sabaleta, our keynote speaker, who has shown us there's a fine line between starting 35 companies and holding a consistent job, while inspiring us to realize the saying, why can't we do something, is actually an idea for a product to the next great thing.
And lastly, let it therefore be resolved that Sigma Zeta offers a special thanks to the given, to be given to Marian University for the use of their brand new facilities and the game at
Gamma Eta chapter for hosting a wonderful
2017
National Convention. Thank you.
Is there
a motion to accept?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? Any abstentions? The motion passes. Website committee.
Yeah.
try and move this as fast as we can, because nobody wants to, like, everybody wants to stay here a lot longer. Website committee is I think, an important committee. The feedback that we get from this group every year helps to enhance what happens on the website, which helps to communicate with you. So I asked them to address three questions this year, and they came up with answers for those. And I'm going to let them share the question with you, and then ask, they can choose. Either pass the sheet to the next person, and each person can read one, or the person that holds the sheet can read them all. So depending on what the person really wants to do. Or the group can lynch persons if they want. So let's start with the first question, which is the positive group. Who's got it? So over here. And say what chapter you're from, what chapter you're from, and what your name. There's not enough answers, so I got to say.
Okay, I'm Chloe Witt from Gamma Gamma, from Concordia College, Moorhead. The Sigma Zeta website is user-friendly and easy to navigate.
Monique Davis, Our Lady of the Lake University, Sigma Chapter. Forms for presentations, registration, and research grants are easy to find and use. Michelle Davis, Sigma Chapter, Our Lady of the Lake University. The images on the site from the front of the page to the convention photo archive effectively portray what happens in Sigma Zeta and recognize events and people like award winners.
Kimberly Coy, Evangel University, Beta Eta Chapter, and the site is mostly pretty mobile friendly.
I'm Greta Knefkamp from the Beta Iota Chapter, Bethel University. And important information for chapters to use locally is helpful, complete, and easy to locate on the site.
Okay, and those that didn't read something, still introduce yourself, because the director only asked for 5 questions and there's more than 15 people.
Okay. All right, well, I'm Whitney Gray from the Pi chapter at Milken University.
Okay, so here's some ways that we thought the website could be improved. I'm Josiah Lentz from Gamma Kappa at SBU. And so the first one is, the tabs are a little hard to see, so a horizontal menu might make them easier to find.
Cameron Dodge from Beta Eta Chapter of Evangel University. And the home page could use a bit more pizzazz with color images, etc.
Trey Shook from Beta Eta Evangel University. More images and images that change, like slideshows or rotating images.
I'm Carlos Bras from the Alpha Eta chapter, also Olivet College. I guess it's the same thing. The third suggestion was, fourth suggestion was the use of teaser news text to be less wordy on the home page.
My name is Chris Neth. I am from the Beta Eta chapter at Evangel University. And our last way that we can make the website better would be to incorporate a simple way to order and pay using credit cards.
I'm Danny Braun. I'm from the Gamma Gamma chapter at Concordia College in Minnesota.
I'm Amelia Ammon, also from the Gamma Gamma chapter at Concordia College in Minnesota.
I'm Catherine Cappell from the Alpha Beta chapter at Campbellsville University in Kentucky.
I'm Aubrey King. I'm from the Row Down the Road chapter from the University of Indianapolis.
Caitlin Bailey, Row chapter, University of Indianapolis. And we talked about how we can increase communications within and between chapters. To help meet deadlines, timely reminders for upcoming due dates, for example, research grant proposal and report, convention registration, and presentation abstracts would be very helpful. To help increase the accessibility with less scrolling, important resources and information could be placed in a wider information block located above the more dense lower informational columns. To help promote local and national chapter involvement, more consistent and more frequent brief communication from the national chapter could also be very helpful. To aid in promoting, sharing, and interaction between local chapters, adding interactive components to the websites, like forum and photo posts, could also be helpful.
Well, thank you. I just want to ask that one question. Did that capture the gist from my notes of what actually you said?
Yes.
Okay. Is there a motion to accept their report?
So moved.
A second?
Yes.
All in favor?
Aye.
Any oppositions? Any abstention? The motion passes.
Developing the National Service Project for 2017. So what we're going to do, we had a tremendous group of students to work with. We sat last night at the table and brainstormed a number of different ideas. And so I'm going to, because we have so many people, I'm going to kind of throw the mic around and everyone's going to get to introduce themselves, chapter and college.
Hello, my name is Catherine Crank and I'm from Evangel University's Beta Theta chapter.
Hi, I'm Glory Com. I go to Concordia College and I'm from the Gamma Gamma chapter.
I'm Jenna Stillo from Concordia College, and I'm from the Gamma Gamma chapter.
I'm Tori Agadinsky. I'm from Marian University's Gamma Eta chapter.
Hi, I'm Robin Fettig. I'm from the Gamma Gamma chapter at Concordia College.
Hi, I'm Jess Watson. I'm from Concordia College, from the Gamma Gamma chapter.
I'm Laura Kirk from the Beta Zeta chapter at the University of Parkville.
I'm Katie Leger from the Gamma Kappa at Southwest Baptist University.
I'm Julianne Ingram from the Beta Eta chapter at Evangel University.
I'm Melissa Gadd from the Beta Eta chapter at Evangel University.
I'm Sydney Reynolds from the Rho chapter at the University of Indianapolis.
I'm Taylor Howersberger. I'm also from the Rho chapter at the University of Indianapolis.
I'm Alicia Basil from the Phi chapter at Eureka College.
I'm Jordan Thomas. I'm from the Sigma chapter at RLA at Lake University.
I'm Sarah Thur from Bethel University. Beta Iota chapter.
I'm Erica Forbes from the Pi chapter at Wilhelmina University.
I'm Megan Agpi from the Alpha Beta chapter at Alva College.
Hi, I'm Bethany Webb from the Alpha Beta chapter at Campbellsville University in Kentucky.
I'm Allie Nowrider from Alpha Beta at Campbellsville University.
All right, so because we have so many people and it's a bit longer, we're going to have two of the students from the Gamma Gamma chapter kind of introduce the title, and then Bethany's going to come out and read the main body of the service project. So Bethany, if you'd like to join us across here.
Yeah.
So Jess and Robin are going to basically kind of give a little bit of the idea that led us to this, and then basically introduce the title.
So our title of this is Highlighting the Impact of Science on Everyday Life.
And we kind of took the idea from last year and made it better.
We recognize that in these troubled times that there exists an increasing gap between the non-scientist and the scientist, and we hope each chapter takes up the challenge of undertaking projects highlighting to all the importance of science in everyday life. The ubiquity of science is evident in everything we do, whether it be in the products we use or the phenomena we see around, and it is our hope that we can use this to build connections with our non-scientist colleagues, friends, and communities. We should seek to share not only our knowledge of the science around us, but also our passion and the sense of wonder we all experience in what we do, and use this to showcase the importance of science to everyone. We should remain mindful of the wealth of resources available in health to communicate effectively with our communities, and it is hoped through this, we also gain a new perspective ourselves on the importance of science. We would also task those undertaking projects under this banner to incorporate both mathematics and engineering wherever relevant to strengthen the connection of all aspects of the STEM field. We would like to propose specific challenges of reaching out on our campuses to the non-STEM disciplines and showcasing the underlying science in these fields and where relevant other extracurricular activities, along with the challenge of creating activities based around the theme of a day without science, an opportunity to reflect on what our lives would be like in the absence of scientific progress.
Thank you very much, and thank you very much to all of the committee who helped us put this together, who brainstormed ideas.
I need a motion to accept. Second? All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposition or abstentions? The motion passes.
Next will be the historian will give us a serious and also a humorous PowerPoint, I believe, on the history of Sigma Zeta and specifically this chapter. We'll talk about this new chapter. While she's getting set up, these are totally random. I'm calling out the names of everybody that presented. If you could come up, maybe Bob, our webmaster, would like a photo op so that you can... If I slaughter your name, please let me know. Alicia Basil? How was that?
Perfect.
Oh, thank you. Tough one. Joe Barnes. Robin Fennig. And then Madison Frame, you can be coming down. We'll try to speed this up a little bit. Madison Frame? Does anybody know Madison Frame? Or is that...
Okay.
Catherine Kappel or Capel?
It's
Kappel. Kappel, okay. Michelle and Monique, you can be coming down next to Davis. Allison, the writer? How bad was that?
Not
Knight Rider. Bethany Webb, you'll be next. Bethany Webb.
What's it called? It's cross.
Michael Christian, you're next. Katie Miller. Katie Miller. Jordan Thomas is next. Luke is an RN. RN? He's not here? Oh, thank you. Cheyenne Steinberger, was she the sick one?
Yeah.
So you're accepting the
sick one. Oh.
Okay.
Where's your...
Here
you go.
Oh,
while you're here.
Oh, you guys are... Cheyenne, the one from the sick one.
Yeah, okay.
Brittany Miller. Brittany Miller. Tracia. Shoop. Haley Suttle. Heather Culbertson. Heather Culbertson. Kevin Hammond. Kevin Hammond.
Can you use the microphone when you call the names?
Say it again.
Could you please use the microphone when you call students' names?
Thank you. Adam Lesniak.
Thank you.
Zach Peterson.
It's not that bad. It's during the school year where it gets hard, but you can pick up a lot more opportunities.
Sarah Barron? Barron? How bad was that? Kenzie Wild. Kenzie Wild. Manny Howard. Jenna Stillwell. Danielle Brown. Brown. Danielle.
Oh my God.
Chloe Witt.
Last name.
Benjamin Stubb.
Oh yeah, it's called Ron Darwin.
Willid.
Ruth Sexton.
I kind of expected mine to be so. I mean, I don't know.
Ariana Huber.
There's only one of them. Yeah, one of the stuff. I mean, what am I going to do? Wipe my tears away.
Amelia Amon. Megan. Dunderlinger. Jessica Watson. Michael Salt.
Sigma Zeta, what it is, and at the end I'll talk a little bit about Marian University, but the thing about the Marian University is this is their first convention, so I don't have a whole lot to say, but we can add to it, right? We can always add to it. Of course, we know that's our nice little banner we have there. We may have to try to get a little bit better picture put on the PowerPoint for that one. I'm sure we can get a better That one looks a little, maybe it's just because it's projected, that's not, doesn't look too good. Okay, this is actually the Sigma Zeta organization, what we're doing, and how it consists. And after this time, I probably need to try to make an addition to it, because we're going to have a student representative on it. Okay, so this is how we have our governing body, the national chapter, our council, and all that. Okay, this little picture of this man in the corner is supposed to be the tallest guy in Illinois. I forgot his name. Anyway, Sigma Zeta was founded in 1925 at Sherliff College in Alton, Illinois. And the founders was Elmer List, who was a biologist and geologist. Ellis Powell, who was a mathematician, and Ralph Carlton, who was a chemist. Well, gee, that's what we are, right? You know, a few years later we did have computer science, but that's the ones that actually founded it was the chemistry, biology, and mathematician. Okay? It was actually a local recognition for the Shirtlift math and science. That's how it began. Okay, because they wanted some way of recognizing these honor students. So it was a regional honor society to begin with. Okay. So it actually attracted interest from Eureka College and McKendree. Yay, McKendree, but McKendree's not here today.
Eureka's here, right?
Yay.
The oldest attending chapter.
So membership was restricted to upperclassmen of high academic standing. And the first conclave, that's actually what we can call a convention now, okay, it was the first conclave, was held at Shirtlift College in June of 1926. And the National Constitution was adopted at that meeting, and there was the names of the first officers. They didn't call them president, vice president, they were grandmasters, and the vice grandmaster scientists. They didn't call them president, vice president back in the day. Okay? And of course we had a historian and reporter. Okay? The first order of business was to grant a charter to McKendree, okay? And they were called the Beta Chapter. The first banquet was held and had a guest speaker, Dr. H.L. Davis at that time. He was an alumni of the Shirtlift College. First chapters outside of Illinois was chartered in May of 1927, Medical College of Virginia, which was the Gamma Chapter, which was in Richmond, Virginia. The Northeast Missouri State Teachers College, which was the Delta Chapter in Missouri. And the meetings were held biannually. The chapters were established also in Wisconsin, Ohio, Missouri during the 1929 conclave. I'm not sure, do we still have a Wisconsin chapter?
Not active.
I didn't think we did. I don't remember Wisconsin, but I didn't think we still had one active. The first Sigma Zeta was published in 1929, and if you go back and look at your SigmaZeta.org site, you can actually go back and look at it. Okay, go look at the Sigma Zeta and you can actually see what the first one looked like. Not near as nice and fancy as what it is in the last few that's published anyway. The first conclave held outside of Illinois was in Missouri. The first seven chapters was commemorated, I'm going to twist it here in a minute, with the official gavel in 1930. The gavel should be going around the room. It's not probably not walking, right? It's going around the room. If you look at it, you can actually see the different woods, okay? And here is a diagram of the gavel, okay, and where each part of the wood came from, okay? The center cylinder was from an oak beam from a home at the Shirtlift College. The six surrounding segments include a mahogany segment which supports the handle and is encased in a physics lab at Otterbein College, the Epsilon Chapter. The light-colored wood from a stair rail at Central State College, Teachers College, and from the Zeta Chapter. Okay, the piece of walnut from northeastern Missouri come from the Delta chapter. The yellow pine came from the Medical College of Virginia, which represented the Gamma chapter. The spruce segment from the original flooring at the Science Hall at Southeast Missouri State. Okay. Like I said, I'm trying to do two things here. There we go, baby. Okay. McHenry College, represented with the walnut segment from the frame of an old laboratory apparatus. And we have McHenry's one that didn't show up today. That was registered, but they didn't come because of financial situations. So this gavel is a contribution of F.A. Hennewalt, the faculty sponsor of the Epsilon chapter and twice national president. We have the plate where the gavel strikes. Okay, it was presented to the society in 1977. Strike plate, and it actually has names of the contributing chapter names that's found on the records on the front of it. At the end of every convention, the president will pass the gavel to president-elect, who then becomes president, and that's usually the one I put up there because there's such a difference in height there. But like I said, it's a little bit a comedy here. This Joe's here though, right?
I have a lot more hair then.
Well, see just look at that, right? Must be hitting the wrong button. I'm not hitting it well enough. Like I said, it's might be a multitasking thing for me to do two things at one time. Okay, the World War II. There was 15 chapters in 1940, and the jewelry and the coat of arms was designed at 1932 conclave. The induction ceremony and initiation race was also approved in 1932. The Ada chapter was the first chapter to become inactive. The first student papers were presented in 1942. And at that time during World War II, a lot of the faculty advisors were called out to war. That's when they did the drafting and when there were wars and everything. So that did a not so nice thing about having meetings and everything. Sponsors, teachers would have to sponsor because they were going to war. The 1946 conclave was held with the AAAS National Meeting in St. Louis. The Founders Cup was awarded for the first time in 1947, and we'll be doing that a little bit later today. Presented by three founding faculty members from the Shirtland College, we presented the first Founders Cup. If you notice, if you look up here on the Founders Cup, there's actually names carved in the bottom of it. That's actually is what's done on the Founders Cup. It's when you win a Founders Cup, your name is put on it. Of course, we have an original Founders Cup, and then we have another one that's going around. Travel expenses were $25. Wow. Back in 1950. Shirtland College became part of Southern Illinois College, and then we have established our honor award in 1961. And we had received the honor award. The associate chapters, we established those in 1969. We have probably, I'm not sure exactly, maybe four.
Three
and one that's possible that could come up shortly. So we've had numerous chapters established in the 70s, 80s, 90s, and I need to change that. I know that's incorrect. Okay. Okay, so I have there for 73 chapters. I knew I needed to change something else. That needs to be changed. I need to correct that. There is more than 73 chapters. And active chapters, we had one chapter just recently that was inactive, now has become active. So that number will be, you know, different too.
We have over 50 active chapters. That means in the last 3 or 4 years they've added new members. I think with the two chapters that are going to be joining us in Florida next month, that'll put us up to like 84.
87.
I should know that. 86 maybe?
86.
I should know that off the top of my head.
Current national headquarters is out at Lady of the Lake in San Antonio. We have executive council consists of 8 faculty, executive director, president-elect, president, past president, publicist, treasurer, webmaster, and historian. Like I said, I'll go with the wrong numbers again. The number of chapters and number of associate chapters. That was, I think, what was listed in the 2010 edition of the Constitution, so I need to get the more up-to-date one and correct that.
We'll be adding a national officer in a few minutes.
Yes.
At 9.
Average number of new initiates is around 500 per year, and I think that's actually increased to close to 800, hasn't it? Yeah, it's close to 800. Okay, this is actually an old map that we had, paper map, and actually the reason I keep it up there, even though it's not accurate, is because, you know, it was an old map and doesn't look too great anymore. I don't think we even carry it with us anymore, but I just keep it because it was the map that we had at one time with all the little dots of where chapters are. And the thing of it is, we've got more chapters now, and you actually go online to the Sigma Zeta. .org, and you can see a more up-to-date map. Okay, I think I've got it. That one's in interactive link up there. Okay, the Gamma Native chapter. They were installed in November of 2012, approximately 50 members listed on the charter. This is their first convention hosting. So in the future, when I do a history of they do a post again and I'm still around. What happens is I put some highlights of the convention of the people would hear. What I do is maybe put up a couple resolutions about how many chapters attended and those kind of things under their history. So when I get back to my office next week, I'll probably try to update it before I forget. You know, how many actually attended at this convention and maybe a couple of the resolutions and have those already on the PowerPoint. In 2014, the Gamma Eta chapter actually received the Founders Cup Award. So they've been active just about ever since they joined. They've been an active chapter. And home, I actually found a few pictures to put up off the website, to put up about the pictures of Gamma Eta chapter. Did we have fun? That actually is a picture actually from the previous historian. I just thought it was cute, so I left it on there.
Is there a motion to accept the report of the historian?
Yes.
Second?
Yes.
Everyone in favor?
Aye.
Any opposition? Any abstentions? The motion passes. All right, so nominations committee. This is the big business of the organization for tonight.
Thank you.
drag and drop. That's kind of cool. Okay, so this is the nominations committee. I'm Joe Burnell, co-advisor for Road Chapter. I'll let you introduce yourselves.
I'm Heather Gilbertson from Indianapolis University's Beta Eta Chapter.
I'm Rebecca Dahl from Gamma Gamma from Concordia College.
Kenzie Wild, Concordia College Gamma Gamma Chapter.
I'm Ruthie Sexton. I'm from Gamma Gamma at Concordia College.
I'm Joe Barnes. I'm from Gamma Kappa, Southwest Baptist.
Jesse Abnett, Road Chapter, University of Indianapolis.
I'm Nikki Raymond, Road Chapter, University of Indianapolis.
Garrison Green, Phi Chapter, Eureka College.
Mia Rachel from the Sigma Chapter at Our Lady of Lake University.
Brooke Smith from the Pi Chapter at Milliken University.
Cole McCamish, Alpha Beta Chapter from Hamilton University.
Leon Carter, Alpha Beta Chapter, Alva College.
Amy Lee Brown, Beta Eta, Evangel University.
Okay, so the nominations committee presents the following slate of nominees for national officer positions. Executive Director Jim Hall, Treasurer David Hahn, Webmaster Bob Kistler, Historian Bernadine Cochran, Publicist Joe Whitaker, and for the elected positions, past President Ann Rammelsberg, President David Stiers Barnett, President-elect Dennis Siegfried, and the student representative nominees are Taylor Hausberger from Rho, Adam Lesniak from Gamma Eta, Paige Swan from Gamma Eta, and we would like to thank Kerry Guffey from Sigma for his long service on the executive committee, most recently as national publicist.
So I guess we need to do this in two steps. We need to have a motion to accept all the elected positions and the committee, or the executive positions, except the student representative, which requires a ballot, right? We're doing that by paper ballot. So is there a motion to accept everything except the student representatives?
Well, first I'd like to close nominations from the floor.
Oh, that's right.
We need to close nominations.
Well, so the first thing is, are there any nominations from the floor for any of those positions?
Webmaster's open.
For Leo, it's really for open.
Move to close nominations from the floor.
We have a motion to close the nominations from the floor. Do we have a second to that?
Second.
All in favor of closing the nominations, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, say no. Nominations are closed. So now do we have a motion to accept the slate of faculty positions down to president-elect? We have a motion for that. Do we have a second? A motion and a second. Then we want to discuss that motion. Any reason why we should not vote for these people? Hearing no discussion, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say no. Motion passes.
So now I'll read off the chapters.
So one representative.
One representative from each chapter comes up to get a ballot for the student representative. Okay. So, Pi Chapter, Beta Eta, Gamma Kappa, Beta Xi, Beta Iota, Sigma, Alpha Eta, Phi, Rho, Alpha Beta, yeah, they're coming down, get it, Upsilon, Gamma Gamma, Alpha Gamma, Gamma Eta, and is there anyone from Alpha Psi present? Alpha Psi? Are there any chapters that I did not call their name that are here? So please fill out your ballots as soon as possible and return them. Do to the front. Please turn in your ballots as soon as possible.
Okay, so rank, so put 1, 2, 3, right? You have to, so your first choice put 1, your second choice put 2, your third choice put 3.
Yep.
Because that will not only be, we will count them if there is a majority of, if someone gets a majority of first place votes, that will end the, election. If no one gets a majority, then we will use a point system to determine the winner. So when you're done, just bring your ballot back up. Once your group has decided, bring your ballot back up. Once you're done conversing with your group, contributing to the ballot, I need the members of the nomination committee to come back up.
Do we have all the ballots yet? We still have a couple of people coming down.
I see a couple of ballots down.
Okay.
And how many ballots should there be?
Oh, please don't mess that up.
Is there still a ballot out?
There's one more coming. Okay. Okay, so we have all the ballots back. Okay. Where would you like us to count these?
Sure.
Okay.
While they're counting ballots, can we get the Founders Cup Committee to come up? Front? Founders Cup Committee? This will save us a little bit of time and get us out of here soon. Because I know some of you are itching to get on the road, so. The Founders Cup Committee?
Yeah. Hello, this is I'm Jim Glasgow from Alpha Gamma, Canton, Ohio, Malone University. We had four applications for this Cup Award, and they were all excellent. They were from Gamma Gamma, Concordia, Roe from the University of Indianapolis, Beta Eta from Evangel, and Marian University, Gamma. So we had four excellent applications. This committee ranked each of the 11 criteria of a point system, and they also considered other things like number of presentations and posters and things like that. So first we'll just do the committee introductions. Start after the statement, right?
Hi, my name is Devarna Ludi. I'm from Alpha Beta Kappa University.
My name is Grace Mahasi. I'm from the Phi Chapter at Eureka College.
My name is Ashley Evans. I'm from the Sigma Chapter at Our Lady of Lake University.
My name is Shelby Stringer from the Alpha Beta Chapter at Campbellsville University.
Avery Walker, Gamma Kappa, SBU.
Amelia Brandt, Gamma Eta, Marian University.
My name is Zach Peterson. I'm from the Beta Iota Chapter from Bethel University.
I'm Corey Franker from the Pi Chapter from Millikan University.
Hello, I'm Jennifer Alliston. I'm from Alpha Beta from Olivet College.
Really close. I kind of wish we had four Founders Cups before this time. So, after all the analysis and item analysis and summaries and all that type of stuff, the winner is, over here, commercial. These are $15.
Now, just a minute. We need to stop just a bit because we also need to gather you around the banner here in some way. Your entire chapter, because your faces will grace the front page of both Facebook and the website. So maybe you want to present it first and then they vote. Let's present it.
You might need to turn the projector off. Representative,
No, that's the sign working off. You guys just saw it. You're the ones that have to take it.
Alpha Gamma Chapter for 11 years. Present the Founders Cup.
Thank you. how do you want to portray your prize award here?
Go down on your knees.
Just think about how you want to be seen for the next year.
Founders Cup business, it's not really fair to take a Founders Cup away from a chapter and not give them anything back to take to their campus. So could I get a representative from the Alpha Gamma chapter, last year's winner, to come up? And you don't have to give this one back, okay? You get to keep this plaque as a remembrance that you were the Founders Cup winners in 2016, Alpha Gamma.
We have the result of the election for student representative. In a very close election among three good candidates, the student representative will be Paige Swan from Gamma Eta.
So Paige will join us at the November meeting. For the first time, we'll have a student member joining the executive committee at the officers' meeting in November. So, congratulations. Okay, so presentation awards. So, do we want to start with posters? Yeah, let's start with posters because you got it right here. And we also need oral, right? And this was not an easy task because there were so many quality posters. So thank you all, the presenters. You did an excellent job. And take this as your introduction to research and go ahead with the future. It looks bright for many of you. Oh, and I'm sorry, my name is Lisa Belts, and I'm from Alpha Gamma. Hello.
And I'm Amy Dykstra from Bethel University, St. Paul, Minnesota, Beta Iota. And I just want to echo what Lisa said, that the posters were just excellent. And it was really difficult to choose a winner or a couple of winners. I'll give you an idea of some of the criteria that helped us distinguish amongst these good ones. We evaluated the posters both based on the presentation and also on the scientific merit. And in looking at particularly scientific method, we were impressed with projects that had a little bit more complexity and showed clearly how the research fit into the field by appropriately referencing other papers. We were impressed by projects that made important contributions to the fields that they were in, and we were really impressed by people who clearly understood what they did and were able to articulate that to us and were able to demonstrate the significance of their results using appropriate methodology and statistics. So those were kind of some of the important characteristics. Would you like to add anything to that list? So, the two posters that kind of floated up to the top amongst all the really outstanding posters were, Okay, so I'll read the title of the poster. So the first one was The Effects of Late Transition Metal Nanoparticles on the Formation of Carbonic Acid, and the lead presenter was Alexander Cardacio.
These are monetary awards.
And the second poster was entitled Different Memory Functions and Microcircuits in the Rodent Hippocampus by Luke Aaron and Caroline Bell.
Say is there were some fantastic talks. Not all of them were experiments. Not all of them went through a scientific experiment. Those are fantastic. The talks you did on outreach, the talks you did on proposals, and talks of informational talks were fantastic. We love those. But in terms of what we were looking for, we were looking for more scientific merit. So with that, hopefully that makes sense. And we would like to encourage those other talks to continue. We certainly love seeing those as well. So hopefully we'll continue to see those.
Well, the best talk award is going to Catherine Capel.
To the Gamma Eta chapter at Marian University in Indianapolis, Indiana, for serving as an excellent host of the March 23rd to 25th 2017 National Convention. Thank you very much.
Couple more awards. We're winding this down. We have a small token of appreciation for our outgoing past president, Mr. Jim Glasgow. Dr. Glasgow, please come forward. For those of you that don't know, it is a three-year term. You first serve as president-elect, then you serve as president. And those of you that were at the convention last year, you remember that Dr. Glasgow was was running the show, like Dr. Remmelsberger is this year. And so a small token of our appreciation. That person, besides running the meeting one year, they contribute immensely at the officers' meetings, both in November and the Thursday night meeting. So it's a nice way for young faculty members to bring fresh ideas to the executive council, just like the student representative. We hope we're going to bring a lot of fresh ideas. So, and then we do have one more. This one's a little bit awkward, but we have an executive, a council member who was really wanting to retire, but we couldn't find anybody to take his place. And so on the chance that possibly this was going to be his last meeting as webmaster, we're going to embarrass Bob a little bit and ask him to come forward for just a thank you for close to 20 years of truly, truly, truly outstanding service. There is no doubt in my mind, as someone who served as the director the last 10 years, that the growth in Sigma Zeta is due to the outstanding webpage that we have. And I actually hear that from chapters that contact me about, sometimes I'm just asking them, there's a lot of honor societies out there. Why did you choose Sigma Zeta? And they said, I went to some other websites and nothing had been updated in 2 or 3 years. And every time I went to the Sigma Zeta website, there was something new out there. So anyway, Bob and I work extremely closely together and exchange emails multiple times a week. So you notice he's coming back next year. So
you need to start recruiting on your campuses if you know a faculty member that kind of likes to play with websites.
So the awkward part is he's coming back, but we're honoring him now. That doesn't mean we can't honor him again. But it was kind of fun having this made up. It's a little heavy. About this organization to just drop us. I mean, he told us a year ago. He gave us a heads up about 2 years ago. He was thinking about retiring. He just cares too much to just drop us, and so we really need to thank him for that again. So.
Do you want to go listen?
Joyce is our next photographer.
I hope this is point two, because that's all I'm thought we just wanted to.
The best part of being president, handing off the gavel to the next president, Dr. David Stiers Barnett. I transfer this gavel and the authority of the president to you.
I'm looking forward to this next year and being able to serve all of you as the president of National Sigma Zeta. I guess it's my first official act as president. I have the honor of thanking everybody for attending this year and our host chapter, Marian, for putting on an excellent convention. And to officially close this meeting.
You want to tell where the next convention is?
Announcements.
Oh, announcements. Are there any announcements?
Next convention host is
Indianapolis
University.
Evangeline, and Springfield, Missouri?
Yep.
Yeah. Yay!
Do we have a date?
Do we have a date? Yes.
Well, it's the host chapter's choice.
It's
going to
be in
the
morning.
Late March.
Late March, as usual. We haven't fixed the location for the officers' meeting, but we will. We were thinking about Honolulu.
I call this meeting to a close for the 2017 National Convention.